The next portion that we are discussing, that is the inflorescence. Okay, the arrangement of flowers on a common axis is known as inflorescence. The arrangement of flowers on a common axis, that is known as inflorescence. It may be either solitary or in group. The inflorescence is classified into two types: racemose inflorescence and the cymose inflorescence. So the arrangement of flowers on a common axis, that is known as inflorescence. It may be either solitary or in group. The inflorescence is classified into racemose inflorescence or cymose inflorescence. Racemose inflorescence means the inflorescence axis grow continuously in racemose inflorescence. The flowers show acropetal succession. Acropetal succession means the old flower at the base and the young flower at the tip. Okay, old flower at the base and the young flower at the tip. The type of succession is known as acropetal succession. For the example for this group is Crotalaria caesia. Caesia means kanikkonna. Okay, so that is racemose inflorescence. So in this, which one is racemose inflorescence? The first figure is the example for the racemose inflorescence, because here the young flower which is seen in the top portion, and the old flowers which seen in the base portion. Again, I am repeating, the inflorescence are two type: racemose inflorescence and the cymose inflorescence. Okay, so the inflorescence exists. The axis grow continuously in racemose inflorescence. This axis grow continuously. The flowers show acropetal succession. Acropetal means old flowers are at the base and the young flower are seen at the top. Example for this group is Crotalaria and the Caesia are the example for this group. Next one is cymose inflorescence. Cymose inflorescence means here is the main axis, and the main axis end in a flower. Here it is continually growing, and here the main axis ends in a flower. So this is the growth is, however, continued by one or more lateral buds arising from the node at which the terminal bud has turned into a flower. Therefore, the growth is termed as definite. And in cymose inflorescence, the flowers are basipetal. Basipetal means older flowers are seen in the top and the younger flowers are placed below. So, older flowers in the top portion and younger flowers are below. This is the basipetal succession or cymose inflorescence. In case of racemose inflorescence, axis grow continuously. One point. The next point, it shows acropetal succession. Acropetal succession means what? Acropetal succession means older flower at the base and younger flower at the top. Example, Caesia, Crotalaria are the example. Then next one is cymose inflorescence. Cymose inflorescence, the axis ends in a flower. The growth is, however, continued by one or more lateral buds arising from the nodes, and here shows the basipetal succession. Basipetal succession means the old flowers are arranged in the top and the young flowers are arranged in the below. Okay, so this the example for the cymose inflorescence, that is jasmine is an example for this. Next is this one. You know this one. In lower classes onwards, we are studying the structure of flower. What are the main features or the main structure of the leaf? What are the main parts of a flower? And what is a flower? A flower is the sexual reproductive organ. Flower is the sexual reproductive organ. And the flower having the main, the flower have, flower is the sexual reproductive part. Okay, reproductive part. And it having the following parts: stigma, style. You can see the stigma, style, ovary. Stigma, style, ovary. These three are the parts of female reproductive system. Anther, the yellow color portion is anther, and they are connected by filament. Okay, and the anther and the filament are the male reproductive part. Then this colorful portion is the petal. Then near to the receptacle portion, near to this receptacle portion, seen a green color leaf-like portion, that is known as sepal. That portion is known as sepal. So here we are detailing studying each portion. So the flower is the sexual reproductive organ of a plant. It has an axis, receptacle, thalamus or torus. Okay, the postion receptacle, otherwise known as thalamus or torus. Then it having the andrecium and the gynoecium. Andrecium means the male reproductive part. Gynoecium means the female reproductive part. And it also having the accessory parts. Accessory parts means which are helps in reproduction. That are known as accessory parts. Calyx, corolla, like that. Okay. So if you are taking a flower, outer calyx, and the inner portion, the colored portion, that is known as corolla. Okay, why the petals are colored? For attracting their pollinators. Okay, suppose the sunflowers are not colorful, but they having the nectar. Nectar means honey-like substances that also attract their pollinators. Okay, so here in this flower, we can see both the male part and the female part. So that's why the flowers in which both the andrecium and the gynoecium are present and that they are functional. That type of flowers are known as bisexual flowers or hermaphrodite. So our hibiscus, China rose, okay, is an example for the bisexual or the hermaphrodite flowers. Understood it is flowers in which both the andrecium and the gynoecium are present. That is known as bisexual flowers. In some cases, some plant having only one type of flowers. Either it is male flower or it having the female flower. Okay, so flowers in which only one of the two sets of essential organs are present, not both. They may be male. So male, only they are having the male reproductive part. That is known as staminate, because stamina is the part of stamina. That is a part of male. So only andrecium is present. The flower is known as staminate. Here I am giving you some terms. You just go through this terms. So bisexual means hermaphrodite. That means both sexes are present. Unisexual means either male or female. If the flower having only male characters, that means it having only andrecium. That is known as staminate flower. If the flower having only gynoecium means the female portion, so that is known as pistillate. So staminate and the pistillate. Okay, then the next is, when the male and the female flowers are present in the same plant, not in same flower I am telling, if the male and the female portions are seen in the same flower. What is the term that is that? Bisexual or hermaphrodite. Here I am telling male and the female flowers are present in the same plant. Okay, don't get confused. So example for that monoecious. So that is known as monoecious. Example for that monoecious is Coccus nucifera. Coccus nucifera is the scientific name of our coconut tree thing. Okay, Coccus nucifera. Okay, then dioecious means when the male and the female flowers are present in different plants, that is dioecious. Okay, example, that is Vallisneria. Vallisneria is a water living plant. Understood what is it? Monoecious means the male and the female flower seen on the same plant. That is very important. Example, Coccus nucifera. And dioecious. Dioecious means when the male and the female flowers are present in different plants. Example, Vallisneria. Next, we are discussing trimeres, tetrameres, pentameres. Tri means 3. Tetra means 4. Penta means 5. Then what is this trimeres? 3. 3 means what? So the monocot studied the differences between the monocot plant and the dicot plant. Okay. In the case of their leaves, the roots, the stem, etc. And in the case of flowers also, they are having some differences. So trimeres means the floral parts in which the each part 3 or its multiples. Monocot plant in the flower 3 or the multiples of the 3 IDQ. Okay. Then in case of the dicot plant, it is the multiples of the 4 or the 5. If it is the multiples of 4, it is known as tetrameres. If it is the multiples of the 5, it is known as pentamerous. So monocot flower has trimerous, multiples of 3. Then the dicot plant and the monocot plant. Dicot plant and the monocot plant. Dicot plant and the monocot plant are the what the features? Dicot plant have, monocot plant having, the flower structure is different. Trimerous condition seen in monocot plant. Then tetramerous or the pentamerous condition seen in dicot plant. So tetra means flow 4 or its multiple. Example for that, ixora. Ixora means techi. Okay. And mustard. Mustard means kadiga is an example for the tetramerous. Pentamerous means floral parts are seen in 5 or its multiple. Then example for that is hibiscus. Then our pea plant. All these are the example for the pentamerous. Clear it is. Clear the term. Trimerous, tetramerous, pentamerous and okay. The next that we are discussing that is actinomorphic, zygomorphic, asymmetric. Actinomorphic, zygomorphic, asymmetric. That means that in dicot flowers are generally characterized by tetramerous and pentamerous that we discussed, and these actinomorphic, zygomorphic and asymmetricals are based on the shape of the corolla. So actinomorphic means regular, actinomorphic otherwise known as regular. A flower in which the petal in each oval are similar to one another, hence can be divided into in any plane. When we cut the flower in any plane, we get the equal halves. That is known as regular or actinomorphic. When we take a flower and we start to cut the flower in any plane, we are getting two equal halves. Okay, that is actinomorphic. Example for that is datura. Datura, chili and mustard. Okay, datura, chili and mustard. Zygomorphic means irregular. An irregular flower. Okay, suppose the flower of cassia, flower of pea, flower of bean, flower of gulmohar. When you start to cut the organism, we didn't get the equal halves. True, only one plane. That is zygomorphic. Asymmetrical means a flower in which the petals are dissimilar. All the petals seen in the flower is dissimilar and it can be divided into equal halves through any plane. In case of asymmetrical, the actinomorphic, we can divide the plant into any plane. Okay, in irregular or zygomorphic, we can divide the flower into only one plane. Okay, in asymmetrical, it is not possible to cut the flower into two equal halves. Example for this asymmetrical plant, that is canna, C-A-N-N-A. It is an ornamental flower. Okay, so on the basis of the shape of the corolla. Corolla means petal. The flowers are arranged into regular or actinomorphic. Then irregular or zygomorphic. Then asymmetrical. In case of actinomorphic, we can cut the plant into, not plant or the flower into equal halves through any plane. Mustard, datura, chili is the example. In irregular, that means zygomorphic, we get the equal halves only through the one plane. In asymmetrical, we didn't get the similar portion in any plane. Okay, example for that is canna. So this is about, these are the main terminology. The next portions are coming there, and these are the some terminologies. Next is some more terminologies are there in the flower, and these are the some terminologies that we are discussed. I hope all you can understand this point. Thank you.